In this video, I'm going to show you how to collect telemetry data generated by the Raspberry Pi and send it to Azure Time Series Insights for storage and visualization.
So the basic architecture here is that data collection and the generation of telemetry data is performed here by my Raspberry Pi, and using MQTT, it is sent to the cloud via the cloud gateway, Azure IoT Hub, which manages bi-directional communication. And then from the IoT Hub, it goes into the Azure Time Series Insights, where it is indexed and stored.
Okay, so I've got a UWP application from a previous video running on this Raspberry Pi and collecting temperature and humidity data from this sensor. And then I'm also reading the value of this potentiometer via the Modbus TCP. So we'll be sending this telemetry data to the Azure Time Series Insights.
Okay, so I'm in my Azure portal. So I'm going to begin by creating the Azure IoT Hub by going to create a resource, Internet of Things, IoT Hub. And then here I'm going to select a resource group to put my IoT Hub. Then I'm going to give my IoT Hub a name. Okay, so the deployment is complete. So I'll go to the IoT Hub that we've just created. And then here I'll go to the built-in endpoints. And then here under events, I'm going to create a new consumer group specifically dedicated for the Azure Time Series Insights. Now that is to make sure that we don't have conflicts with other services that may be wanting to consume the events of the IoT Hub. Okay, and then from here, I go to my shared access policies to copy my connection string that we're going to use later on to send telemetry data to the Azure IoT Hub. Okay, and then from here, I'm gonna go and create my Azure Time Series Insights environment. And then I go ahead and fill in the details from my Time Series Insights environment. Okay, so now we've finished setting up our Azure Time Series Insights environment. So now we go to our device that will be sending the telemetry data to the Azure IoT Hub, which is my Raspberry Pi here. Now, to be able to send data to the Azure IoT Hub from an edge device, we need to install an SDK, a device SDK that will allow us to communicate with the Azure IoT Hub. Okay, so when that is done, go back to my C# file. Then I add the assembly reference. And then I add the declarations. So here I'm instantiating a new device client. This is my IoT Hub URI, and this is my device key. I go to the initialization, then initialize my device and set the transport type as MQTT. Okay, so now that we've successfully created our device, we then want to send the telemetry data to the cloud using the IoT Hub. So here, essentially what I'm doing is I'm creating a JSON object with the properties of device ID, temperature data, humidity data, Modbus data. And then I'm using this method to serialize the object and then encoding the message string. Our method has to be asynchronous. Okay, so now we're ready to deploy our solution. Okay, now, so let's go into our Azure Time Series Insights environment to check to see if we're receiving any telemetry data at all. So what I've done is I've left this running for a while so that you can get a sizable amount of data. So you can see here we've got the data that has been coming through, and then we can filter to see what has been going on in the last 4 hours, and then we can see what has been happening in the past 30 minutes. So there are many ways of digging through this time series data that is stored in Azure Time Series Insights. The most convenient to use is the Time Series Insights Explorer. So here I can view my time series data in the form of a chart, a heat map, or a table. And then I can specify the telemetry data point that I want to view. and I can split that data via the device ID. And then if there's a certain section that interests me, I can select that section to explore the events in detail. So you see here we had a slight dip at 1838. And then you can also adjust the size of your interval to zoom in or zoom out from your time series data. So under the tabular format here, you can actually download the CSV file of the data and perhaps use it to train a machine learning model. Now, the nice thing is that you can easily integrate time series insights into your own custom applications using JavaScript libraries. There are pre-built JavaScript samples that you can customize to create analytics dashboard for your applications. On this one here, you can create bar charts and pie charts straight from your line charts. And then on this one here, you can put markers to your telemetry data to compare values from different times. And you can visualize how your column chart change as you slide through time. And the same thing for your pie charts. Now all this simple code and more for integrating time series insights into your own application is available on GitHub. So as you can see, this is a really powerful way of storing and analyzing your time series data. Thanks for watching. If you've got any thoughts at all on this video, I would love to hear about it in the comment section below. And if you found the video useful, please share it with your connections. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get more videos like this.